Good afternoon, students. So the last topic of our chapter is how to rationalize the denominator. So the fifth question of the worksheet 1.5 is rationalize the denominator of the following. First case is 1 upon root 7. So in case of 1 upon root 7, what you have to do is multiplying and divide the this root 7 with the same number, that is multiplying it with the root 7 divided by root 7. You get numerator ko numerator se multiply kiya, you get root 7, and denominator by denominator we get root 7 into root 7 is equal to 7. So this is how to rationalize the denominator. इतना तो आपने 8th स्टैंडर्ड में भी किया था. उसके बाद नेक्स्ट देखिए, सेकंड केस इज 1 अपॉन रूट 7 माइनस रूट 6. सो यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड द सेम द नंबर सेम नंबर रूट 7 रूट 6. न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू इज सेम बट द साइन इज ऑपोजिट. इफ द माइनस साइन इज गिवन यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय द plus sign. If plus sign is given, you have to multiply and divide it by the minus sign. So 1 upon root 7 minus root 6 can be multiplied by root 7 plus root 6 divided by root 7 plus root 6. We get root 7 plus root 6 ko 1 se multiply kiya, you will get root 7 plus root 6. And here whenever you rationalize the denominator, you get the same answer always, that is root 7 minus root 6, रूट 7 प्लस रूट 6. क्वेश्चन कुछ भी चेंज करके आ सकता है, लेकिन यहाँ पे साइन जो है वो हमेशा डिफरेंट होगा. तो देन यू विल अप्लाई ओनली वन फॉर्मूला हियर, दैट इज ए माइनस बी इंटू ए प्लस बी ऑलवेज. सो हियर यू गेट रूट 7 प्लस रूट 6, एंड इन द डिनोमिनेटर यू हैव रूट 7 स्क्वेयर माइनस रूट 6 स्क्वेयर, दैट इज ए माइनस बी इंटू ए प्लस बी इज ए स्क्वेयर माइनस बी स्क्वेयर. हियर द रूट इज कैंसल्ड विद दिस स्क्वेयर, रूट इज कैंसल्ड विद दिस स्क्वेयर, यू विल गेट हियर 7 माइनस 6, रूट 7 प्लस रूट 6 अपॉन 7 माइनस 6. सो 7 माइनस 6 इज इक्वल टू 1. सो द आंसर इज रूट 7 प्लस रूट 6. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज थर्ड पार्ट इज 1 अपॉन root 5 plus root 2. Same method, multiply and divide by the same term, that is root 5 and root 2 is same, but here the positive sign is given. In the last question here minus sign is given, so we multiplied with the plus sign, and here plus sign is given, we have to multiply it with the by taking the minus sign. Here the numerical value same, root 5 and root 2, so here root 5 minus root 2 divided by root 5 minus root 2. When you multiply root 5 minus root 2 by 1, you get the same term, but here the same method, this is a, this one root 2 is b. Here root 5 is a and root 2 is b. Here positive sign is here, so a plus b, minus sign is here a minus b. So the formula is a plus b into a minus b, we get a square minus b square, that is root 5 square, root 5 whole square and root 2 whole square. So that the square root and square is cancelled, square root and square is cancelled, we get here 5 minus 2 in the next step. So numerator is root 5 minus root 2 divided by 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3. So the answer is root 5 minus root 2 divided by 3. Last part is 1 upon root 7 minus 2 multiplying it with the root 7 plus 2 divided by root 7 plus 2. Same terms are there, but the sign is opposite. But whenever you multiply root 7 plus 2 by 1, we get the same number, but here the denominator, it becomes a minus b into a plus b. The formula for this is a square minus b square. Root 7 square minus 2 square, square root is cancelled with this term, we get 7, and 2 square is equal to 4. So root 7 plus 2 divided by 7 minus 4, that is equal to 3. Okay, these are some questions of rationalization. We will do the extra sums of rationalization on some time else. So the next method is, now the next is laws of exponent for the real numbers. Laws of exponent you have already studied in 8th standard. These are the same questions whatever you have studied in 8th. So the first question of this exercise, last worksheet of this chapter is, first question is 64 raised to power 1 by 2. So you have to write 64 as 8 raised to power 2, because here the base is 1, but the 2 powers are there, and 2 powers, 1 base is there, 2 powers are there, they are multiplied with each other. So 64 can be written as 8 square. 2 is cancelled with 2, we get 8 raised to power 1, that is equal to 8. Second part is 32 raised to power 5. So we have to make the factors of this 32, and we get 2 raised to power 5 whole raised to power 1 by 5. 5 is cancelled with this 5, we get 2 here. Next part, 125 raised to power 1 by 3. 5 raised to power 3 whole raised to power 1 by 3. 3 is cancelled with 3, we get 5 here. Now the second question, 9 raised to power 3 by 2. 9 can be written as 3 square. Whole raised to power 3 by 2. 2 is cancelled with this 2. We get 3 raised to power 3, that is equal to 27. Next is 32 raised to power 2 by 5. 32 can be written as 2 raised to power 5. Whole raised to power 2 by 5. 5 is cancelled with 5. 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. Next part is 16 raised to power 3 by 4. 16 can be written as 2 raised to power 4, whole raised to power 3 by 4, 4 is cancelled with this 4, we get 2 raised to power 3, and 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. Fourth part, I have not done, 125 raised to power 1 by 3, and 125 can be written as 5 raised to power 3, whole raised to power minus 1 upon 3, 3 is cancelled with this 3, we get 5 raised to power minus 1, the answer is 1 upon 5. Now the third question, simplify. First part is 2 raised to power 2 by 3, multiply it with 2 raised to power 1 by 5. The base is same, the sign is of multiplication, so the exponents, the powers are added. So 2 raised to power 2 by 3 plus 1 upon 5. These are the fraction terms, so we have to take the LCM. The LCM of 3 and 5 is 15, so that we get 10 plus 3 here. So 2 raised to power 10 plus 3 is 13, 13 upon 15. Next part is 1 upon 3 raised to power 3 whole raised to power 7. So one exponent is one base is there, and two exponents are there, and both the exponents are multiplied with each other. We get 1 upon 3, 3 into 7 is equal to 21. Next part is 11 raised to power 1 by 2 divided by 11 raised to power 1 by 4. Here the these terms are of division sign, so that in a term, in case of division, the powers, the exponents are subtracted. 11 raised to power 1 by 2 minus 1 raised upon 1 upon 4. The LCM is, LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. We get 11 raised to power 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1 upon 4. 11 raised to power 1 upon 4. Last question, 7 raised to power 1 by 2. Into 8 raised to power 1 by 2. So both the powers, both the exponents are equal, and the bases are different, but their sign is of multiplication. What you have to do, you have to multiply both these numbers, 7 into 8 and whole raised to power 1 by 2, that is 56 raised to power 1 by 2. ये सब आपने 8th स्टैंडर्ड में किया हुआ है. ये जो वर्कशीट है ये 8th स्टैंडर्ड में कर रखी है, तो इसको अच्छी तरह से कर लेना है. तो इसी के साथ आपका ये जो चैप्टर है ये खत्म हो गया है. तो आपने फर्स्ट और सेकंड चैप्टर जो है वो अच्छी तरह से कर लेना है. तो अब इसके बाद हम कल स्टार्ट करेंगे थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री. और कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री के लिए यू नीड द ग्राफ, एंड कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री के जो क्वेश्चंस हैं वो भी आपने 8th स्टैंडर्ड में किए हुए हैं. ठीक है, थैंक यू.